What's up, Badger Nation? I'm Sonny the Badger.
And I'm Angie, Mama Badger, from the Badgers and the Biker Lifestyle on Facebook and supportbikers.com.
And I'm the one that came up with this crazy world record poker run idea. That screwed Mom up.
Yes. Today is, I wrote it down. What's today?
August 4th. December 21st. 22nd, 21st, something like that. Yeah. It's December.
And we're actually on August 4th.
August the 4th.
All right. August 4th, day...
six.
Day six. Yeah, I say that day a bunch six. Of times in this video. Okay.
It's day six!
And we are headed from Durango, Colorado to Golden, Colorado.
Via the Million Dollar Highway.
Million Dollar Highway.
Hills, yes.
Oh, it's beautiful. Can't wait for you guys to see it and our adventure for the day.
And today was an adventurous day.
They all are.
Yes. Today was a very today was an adventurous day as well.
Yep. I can say this topped it for me.
Yeah, we had like reroutes and almost violence and it was pretty wild. Right, Mandy?
I rode, I set. Good morning to day six from Durango, Colorado, the Best Western Harley dealership. Everybody's getting on. Morning! I'm fantastic!
No, actually, I'm gonna fix it and then have it shipped.
It's fucking cold out here.
Fixing, I know. I know.
Yeah.
Oh, good morning, Randit. Good morning, everybody. I'm doing a video about Robert.
Oh, yes.
Truex.
T-Rex,
or RJ, some of you know him as. And here's the update. He did go down in New Mexico on the route here to Durango. We got him here to the hotel. One of the hotel workers took him to the hospital. He
has a few pull tendons.
Pull tendons in his knee.
He has 3 stitches in his hand.
Right thumb.
And he has a possible pelvis fracture.
Yes.
So he is headed home.
Yes, so his sister came and got him. They got his stuff. Bill and Joanna are taking his bike to the Yamaha dealership where they're gonna go pick it up and he's gonna head home. He's super pissed off. Yes, spouses have been fighting on this trip, but they still are having fun, and that's what matters. It's been a challenge. We expected it to be.
MMA coming up.
This is just the way it was.
Made it to Durango, Colorado. Now we're headed to Golden, Colorado, to the Dirty Dogs Roadhouse. For us to party there. Big shout out to Sunshine State Biker Lawyers. We're still doing this. We did have two riders go down, guys. We had Buck Champ. He was in New Mexico when came into a construction area and hit some sand. And so, yeah, he went down. He does have a hairline fracture in his neck and vertebrae. Other than that, no other broken bones. He's feeling like a train just hit him. But other than that, he's in good spirits. In the Million Dollar Highway. This is going to be one of those days that we've been all looking forward to. Never been to Colorado. This is all new for us. We did have to change the route. The route changed because mudslides, and we were told that a certain part of the road was shut down. I'm not sure until October, I heard, but I don't know. We just changed the route just in case, just to make sure that we could get to our destination. Mileage is about the same. Time's going to be about the same. So everybody's getting a little late start this morning because of, I think they're just getting tired. But they're excited. Everybody's good stories. Everybody's having fun. So far it's good. And so here's some video of us doing the Million Dollar Highway and some other craziness that we'll have along the way, I'm sure. So thanks for following along. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Here we go. Day 6 of the World Record Poker Run.
Good morning, Badger Nation. So today is day 6. But most importantly, today is Million Dollar Highway. We've had some pretty epic riding up till now, though. I mean, we rode through the mountains yesterday. It was beautiful. Got a little rain. That was fun. But we had a good time. I know Baby Badger's on here. Mama Badger's on here. Say hello. Hey.
Hello.
Hello.
Anyway, how you guys doing? Are you wore out yet?
Yeah.
I felt like we got 4 hours of sleep last night, so that was definitely nice.
Yes, we got, I'm going to say we're probably in the 6-ish hours last night,
yeah.
Which is about double that we've gotten any night so far.
Yeah.
So, I'm feeling pretty good.
I am too. I'm ready for this.
It is like an awesome temperature. I've got a hoodie on and a long sleeve shirt, and it's beautiful.
I got 3 pairs of pants and 4 layers of shirt.
I think Debbie has overdressed for today, but we'll see.
Go ahead, Dad.
I have 2 layers of socks on too.
Oh yeah. Well, I told her dress in layers, you just take them off as we go. Maybe a little bit of mommy's fault. I would have had it put on leggings under my jeans, and I've got on long sleeve t-shirt, hoodie, and my leather jacket and my big mug this morning. So I'm feeling good right now.
Me too. It's hot when you stop for a little bit, but other than that, it's nice to have this many layers.
Yeah, I'd rather be hotter than colder.
I mean, yesterday I felt like a walking marshmallow.
Yesterday, yeah, we were riding, and I'm shaking so bad, and I'm trying to keep my mouth closed so I don't chop my teeth off, chopping my tongue off with my teeth. It's so cold.
Well, guys, I hope you can see this view, because it is beautiful coming out of Durango, Colorado. What do you girls think? Is that not pretty?
It is beautiful.
I've been dying to ride Colorado. Ride it on a motorcycle. I don't want to live here. I don't want to be here in the wintertime.
Yeah,
we
rode some beautiful yesterday. I mean, we rode in rain a lot, so it was pretty cold. And by the time we got to the hotel room, it was cold. But, man, it was so worth it. It was just phenomenally beautiful and curvy, and man, it was fun.
Sometimes we only saw deer in the light time, not the night time.
Right. So, yeah, we're hoping to get all of today's ride actually in the daylight. If we get to the stop while it's still light outside, that'll be only the second time, with Eureka being the other time.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of people come up and say they're having an absolute blast.
Yeah. Yep. And people are, you know, finding their group of riders that they're, you know, getting along with and feeling comfortable with, and meeting new people, making new friendships, and that's cool to hear.
They're finding their path. We're getting ready to hit the mountain path.
Have you ever, guys ever been through the mountains like this?
Nope, just the ones in North Carolina.
Yeah, North Carolina. That's
I've never been there, so I don't know what that is like.
That's where the Tail of the Dragon and all is.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's a lot like this.
Well, there was like the Virginia really was a mountain, so it was it? Yeah, it kind of
yeah,
was.
The difference is, see, these have like caps where there's no trees. Those are completely covered.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So you can't see like the tops and be like, oh, you know, it just looks like trees everywhere. So these mountains are higher for sure because nothing can grow up there.
Definitely.
I have a feeling I'm going to get cold.
You may. We'll pull over at a stop and you can put some more clothes on.
Cascade Village. That's pretty cool.
That's neat.
That is really neat. I agree.
So we're going to be doing some elevation. You know, we're going to be going
up.
Up, yeah. Down, up,
so
down, up, down.
Just be conscious of your breathing, and if you're having a hard time, let us know.
Whee! Just go around the corner really fucking fast!
Yep.
It is pretty.
It is beautiful.
Dude, we'll get warm as we get higher up into the...
Yep.
Mountain.
Well, no, once you get up so high, it gets colder.
Yeah. If there's snow, we're not going to be able to feel much.
I don't see any snow on top of these mountains.
I don't either.
Yay.
I want to go there.
No.
Okay.
Wait, hold on. It's not gravel.
It is concrete.
It's concrete.
Oh, God.
This is perfect. It's concrete. We're good. Ha-ha! I found a place to stop! There's everybody.
Are you okay?
Well, what did you do?
That's the question. I got a little excited.
This is beautiful. Time to put in another battery.
SIM card never been used.
Are you sure? Yeah. Where did I put the other one at?
Huh?
Where do I put
and this
the other
one happens when you're
if you want to give it to me, I can put this it with one? All my others. Yeah, that's your SIM card.
You need to make sure you have that's enough battery and you got enough space on your SD card. And so you pull over so you can take in the view. We just came from there and we're headed that direction. And you'll see some road down there. Oh, it's breathtaking, guys. I wish you were here. Roads are super easy to ride on. If you're watching this, the roads are easy. They're really, really easy. I think people just get scared because of this. You can see the road over there. But other than that, I mean, you're going slow speed and you actually get to take in the scenery. A lot of other roads we've been on, South Carolina and Virginia and Tennessee, there's so many trees you can't see everything, but this, I mean, you can actually see out. I didn't even know it's way over there too, is the other part of the road. And that's what makes the Million Dollar Highway breathtaking. We got Key Fob Bob, real name Doug. We got Tim, Sonny, Baby Badger, me and John Price's bike, Miss Amy, Stevie Foe. Go follow on YouTube. We have Man in the Machine and Michelle from Bill's Fries. Girl, you been on this already?
What, baby?
Have you been on this already? Oh, there she said her. I totally forgot her on our signs. Hello. There you go. Woo, woo. Oh. Doug's got two. Whip out that side. Whip it out, baby. Whip it out. Whoop, whoop, whoop. There he goes. He came, he rode, and he's going to sit here a couple more days. So have you been on this, Belle?
On this road?
Yeah.
Not on this one.
Okay, so
not
this
portion. I've been on 70 a lot of times.
Hashtag crackhead.
What are you doing?
Making
videos.
Dance.
Yeah, now you're gonna get down.
Now she's trying to get down. Jeez.
All right.
guys are in Silverton. Anybody want some gas and a bathroom?
Yeah.
Looks like it's gravel, so be careful.
What's
come on
plan?
Over here. I'm going to get some gas and people are going potty. I just want Desi to have gas, really. We don't really need it.
We
unless
don't.
You want some.
So do I need to fill?
Might as well.
We just don't know how long till that gas with mountains and all.
All right, guys. Stopped at this gas station.
I think because I've got the jacket on, you know, I can't see it.
Yeah.
So.
A bad hair day, honey?
Yeah. Gonna be.
I know,
end of the day, yeah. I'm definitely gonna be showered and washed, but I get all the rest.
Look at that.
Wow. Oh,
a
lot of
the gold. And the rocks.
Yeah.
From the red.
Cannabis farm tours.
Ooh, look at that.
No, because then it'd be on foot up there. That's why the sign says falling off, right?
We're probably why they closed the freaking let the boats down. If it's raining, they're probably closed down.
Landslide is what it would be.
Did you tell Mom about Joe?
Yeah.
Joe
is
on the road.
Oh, and Mom's dead.
ETA is 7:15.
Us will be there?
Yep. Well, we're gonna have to stop for gas a couple more times. So we can be there by 9. I'll be surprised. You hearing me, Mama?
So we'll be there till 9?
I'm guessing. It says 7:15. By the time we stop and get gas a couple more times. Elevation is 10,000 feet.
What'd you say?
All right, guys, so we're back. We're on the $1 million highway. It is breathtaking. Something in the road there.
Let's see it.
All right, look at that. Look straight forward, lady.
Oh my God.
It's almost like gives you this optical illusion.
Yeah. I have to keep looking at the road in front of me. So,
get out there.
I have never seen anything like this. It's fucking nuts. Oh my God.
Tunnel of love. Tunnel of love.
Let's see the top of the pulley cart thing. Did you see it?
Yeah.
It was a pulley cart thing.
Holy party thingy. I like it. Good explanation.
Gosh, look where the road is going.
Yep, right along the
bluff. It's so freaking evil. National Forest.
It just keeps going and going. I mean, typically when you're on roads like this, they ask you.
Like the Energizer right. Bunny. All right, guys, this is going to be a really cool park. Check out how close we are to the mountain, riding on this little two-lane road. You can see the mountain up ahead of us. Guys, if you ever get a chance to ride the Million Dollar Highway, I highly, highly, highly recommend. There's going to be rocks in the road due to, you know, slides and all. There's a big rock right there. Keep your eyes out for rocks. Talk about a drop-off, ladies and gentlemen. Looks like the road's about to just fall.
Better hold tight, spider monkey.
Ride in and stay a night or two.
An ambulance is not a good sign, people. Oh. Not a good sign.
TBACs are all stopped there. Yep.
They stopped there.
You did?
Tampa Bay area cruisers. That was their, some of their bikes there.
What do you think, guys? Is this a cool little town or what? Pretty neat, I think.
You should honk as we go there. You ready?
Where?
Where? There's all those people up there.
What the fuck are we honking?
I don't know. The car went to the car.
Whoa, does nope. Bye.
Oh, yes, bye.
Oh, bye.
Fort Ouray, Colorado, O-U-R-A-Y. But well, there are some hot springs here. I've seen the sign.
There's
a hot spring there. Yeah, I would love to ride in here. Stay a couple days. It'd be pretty cool. Angie, put that on our list.
Yeah. Well, it's
O U R. What was it called? O U R A Y.
Yeah. Ouray. Yeah, there's a lot of cops and shit going that direction. That is probably not a good sign.
That's not good. Not. We'll be right back. right. Taco Bell break, because route change, the Independence Pass is closed. We just found out. Brian, our route coordinator, been on the phone with him, talking to him. I got everybody camping out, waiting to see what happens next. We're getting a detour here to go, to bypass the mudslides that apparently happened and that we need to reroute from. So entertaining. All flipping around here, you guys can see we got more people inside. We've been calling ahead to all the riders that we know and letting them know, hey, stop in Carbondale, and from there you'll get directions on where to go. So we're hoping, fingers crossed, that we can catch everybody and that they get a text message from us and they get a go on River and see the new wrap on River, and of course the website. So the website will have the new route on it as well. So I'm gonna get off here and get to working.
All right, guys. So yeah, we stopped. It took an hour to do all of that. So we're an hour behind. Mm-hmm. And then we have people ahead of us that are even further behind because we had to backtrack. So we'd already passed the road we needed to take. So we had to go back the way we came and then take the other road.
Yeah, poor people ahead of us that...
Yeah, some of them got in at what, 3 or 4 in the morning.
But we found out that Independence Pass was actually open because we did have riders that went through.
Yeah, so we found out later, and Brian like apologized 1,000 times, and it wasn't his fault. But the state had put out an alert that they had closed the pass, because since they'd already closed I-70, a lot of trucks and car traffic was going through Independence Pass, and they were trying to lighten the load. Mm-hmm. So they basically lied to all of us and said that it was closed. So we could have went that way, and we could have been there a lot earlier. Thanks a lot, Colorado.
Yeah.
We appreciate you.
We know Brian tried. He called them. He did everything he possibly could to help us out, and we appreciate it.
He left work. He left work early, guys. So he left his 9-to-5 job that pays his bills and said, look, guys, I got to go take care of my riders. So, I mean, if that's not going above and beyond, I don't know what is.
And he kept his job, thank God.
And he's still employed. So we can't thank him enough for all he did. No. It was just an unfortunate set of circumstances that made our day considerably longer.
Yep. Okay. On we go.
To the next episode.
Rock. That's crazy. Yeah. Alright, so while I'm videoing, I'll tell everybody what's happened. So, in an earlier episode, you saw the Badgers and some of the Sport Bikers crew all headed to Golden, Colorado
to hang out at a Taco Bell
for the World Record Buzzer Run. We're actually headed to Dirty Dog. And we had our route all planned, and we're just cruising, and then the road we were going to take got closed. So now we've been rerouted to the land of Oshif and Rocks on the road. So this is what we get. Look at all these rocks. I'm guessing this road was probably closed not too long ago. And they just got her, like, cleared off with these machines. Ooh. This is definitely interesting, ladies and gentlemen. Blackout Devil, what are you doing to us, buddy? Look at all this rock that's falling. It's a pretty view.
That doesn't even look real.
That is pretty.
Yancey National Recreation Area. So now I'm going to repeat that.
Yeah. I can just replay it on the recording.
Yes. Yancey National Recreation Area.
California. Who looks like a rat in Idlewild?
Wow. Like we're just gonna run right into it.
Yep.
That's good, because he's used to the Atlantic, right?
So. Right. That's beautiful.
Wow.
Big dam,
huh? Yeah, it is. Black Canyon National Park.
I guess.
It's 65.
Yeah, I guess Ryan has redeemed himself. This is pretty as well.
Yes, Ryan, what?
Has redeemed himself. This is pretty as well.
This is pretty as well, yeah.
Oh, we're gonna go over that bridge.
Oh, cool.
Oh.
Check this lineup. This is the entire crew riding with us today for this leg of the World Record Truck Run. So we cannot wait. Give me a big wave! Nice! That'll give me some ratings.
So I remember everybody saying how it was going to be a party every night. I don't think that happened.
No. It might have before we got there.
Maybe, but I'm not thinking so.
That really surprises me, though.
First day or two, everybody figured out that this was going to kick everybody's ass.
Yeah. Sleep is important.
Yes.
Stopped on the side of the road again. Bundling up to get warm. Because it's getting cold. Temperature's dropping. Going into the mountains again. Places that aren't chains
suck ass. Yes, I said it. It's 10:30 and I'm tired as hell. I'm freezing cold and the hotels are a freaking mess. Oh, here comes, we've got Joanna, we got Bill, Mike, some other people finally rolling in. Yeah, I mean, this is crazy. This whole hotel thing has always been a freaking mess. Every time you schedule reservations, you call them and they're like, no, we don't have reservations. Are you kidding me? We scheduled reservations. Why do you not have them? So I'm sitting here. I'm sitting outside just waiting for that to get figured out. And I thought I would get on here and start talking. Get out what I can. So after we went and did the whole freaking route thing, rerouting it, the TBACs, Tampa Bay Area Cruisers, found us at the Taco Bell, and so they took off, and they were probably 30-45 minutes ahead of us, and unfortunately, we got called, like, mile marker 198 after, I can't even remember the name now, Guinnesson, mom and dad came up on them. They turned a sharp corner and there they had a man down. So they pulled ahead because there was no place to stop at, and ambulance came, sheriff came, fire truck came. I have no clue. I have not talked to the parents. I have no idea. What's going on with the hotel?
Oh, they've got it so fucked up. We've got a signed contract for 15 rooms. They have 8 rooms available for us. So we have a lot of people that don't have a fucking place to stay tonight. And Mandy about crawled over the fucking desk and decked the dude.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. I thought she was going to crawl right over the desk.
Were we videoing that? Sign contract. 15 fucking rooms. Where's our room?
Yeah, so Origin Hotel Red Rocks. Don't ever fucking stay here.
Oh, sorry. Nope. Thumbs down. 0 stars. Ridiculous. We called last week. We called last week to confirm. So... they're over there. It's like, you didn't video Mandy. Alright, well, I've got to figure out which rider went down and reach out to them and figure out what's going on. So that's probably what I'll do when I get off here, is talk to my mom and see who it was and how we can help. Didn't make it to Dirty Dogs Roadhouse tonight. It's 10:30 tonight. Kept in touch with Lori and let her know. And food... of course, we haven't had any food, and so we're starving and freezing and starving, and I'm so tired I can't think. So I don't know, I don't even know what else to talk about. It was a fun day. It always is, but it gets to be night like this and you're just tired and you're just done, and I'm at that point. So good night. Be sure to share, like, subscribe, and comment below if you want to. This is end of day 6 of the World Record Poker Run. Good night.
Whew, I was done.
Could Mama you tell? Badger was done. I was done. I do have to tell a little story that's not in here. So one of our veterans, A-Rod, or Alex Rodriguez. So he was in there at the counter as me and the little kid behind the desk were conversing. And so he's a military veteran, guys, but he is doing this to me while I'm talking to him. And I never even thought about it till like the next morning. And he's like, man, you did good. Because I wanted to break the little boy in half. And so did Amanda. I was tired. I was cold. I was everything Angie was, and I was pissed off.
Yeah.
So, you know what?
You did. I didn't think of it in the heat of the moment, but I'm sure that helped. So, A-Rod, thank you. For having my back, one way or another, man. One way or another. Anyway, guys, so that was it. We finally figured it all out. It took us about 3 hours to figure out all the hotel rooms, but we did figure them out. We got everybody in for the night, and everything ended up working out okay.
Yeah, everybody had a room to stay in.
Everybody did stay in a room. So,
but poor Sonny, he even called that week too.
And so I'll be honest, guys, so. I called. We started in July. Every week in July, I had called the hotels to make sure reservations were all set. They had the right number, everything. So I had done everything in my power. So that's what made it like extra frustrating for me, because I had called these jackasses and nobody, I mean, what the heck? And so, yeah, I was infuriated. And then the little kid behind the desk was just like, it's no big deal, which was when Amanda was going to break him in half.
Yeah. It
was a big deal. I mean, we were all upset.
We had
been through, and it was.
We were ready to go to bed.
It was a mess. But anyway, it all worked out. We had a good time. This was by far the coldest night that we rode, and the darkest.
Bottles of beers on the wall, right, girls?
And it was dark. And, it was so dark coming in. Just that mountain pass was
99 bottles of beer on the wall. Yeah,
I clicked my mic off because I did not want to listen to that.
We literally was singing that just to get us by, for that time.
It was crazy. It was insane, but it all worked out. All stories, all memories.
Yeah. Yeah.
And our next episode, we will cover going from Golden to Cheyenne. And it was a little less eventful.
Sorta.
It had its things, but I don't know if it was quite this eventful.
It was pretty too.
It was pretty. So had a blast. And guys, we will not have a video next week.
Oh yeah.
The week between Christmas and New Year's, we're taking off, guys. We're doing our best to take off. We have been nonstop since last like October when we decided to do the world record poker run. And we just
well, and these time. Videos, one of them took me 18 hours to edit it. So
yeah, they take a long time. And we just need a break.
Yeah.
So we're going to take one.
We apologize. No World Record Poker Run video series coming out. Or premiere coming out next Wednesday. Hey, I said it right.
But next year, we'll have more.
Yeah, next year. Stay tuned. And we'll pick it back up on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. again. The first of the year.
All right, guys. Remember, if you love videos like this, give us a
thumbs up.
Hit that.
Subscribe button.
Ring that.
The like button.
And remember, guys, it's not about the destination.
It's all about the ride.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, guys.
Happy New Year.
Next year.
Bye.
In 2022.
Into his house.